More than half of Australian grandparents are playing a very large role in assisting younger family members with their finances. That's according to new research.
Among the younger generations, 60% received financial support before adulthood. This compared with just 20% of Gen X and less than 10% of baby boomers.
But at what cost are grandparents nowadays footing the bill? Well, for more, we're joined by social researcher guru Mark McCrindle. Hey, Mark.
Hello.
OK, so what sort of support are grandparents providing and how does this change from what they've always done?
Well, yeah, it's help with housing, it's sometimes help with education expenses, helping the grandkids get a first car or pay other bills. They're far more likely, in fact, the grandchildren of today are 10 times more likely to have received financial support from their grandparents than the grandparents ever received when they were grandkids. So it's at a whole new level today.
You can understand, can't you, Mark, people needing to leverage whatever they can given the cost of living crisis and how hard it is, but at what cost to the grandparents? Too much cost?
Well, it can come at a cost. I think grandparents need to consider that. You know, they might be excited to help out that first young adult grandchildren, but there might be more grandchildren coming after that, so they need to keep that in mind and pace themselves a little bit. But, you know, the fact is that young people today are starting their own earnings years later in life, and they've got bills and debt that they carry, so they need a bit more support than perhaps the grandchildren of the past. They're certainly needing a bit of help with the finances, as you said, on the cost of living and housing. The gap between even when they get a job, what they earn and that house is greater than it's ever been before.
It's interesting, isn't it, because it seems that grandparents are now saying, oh, well, you're going to end up with it anyway, so I may as well give it to you now while you really need it. But are they actually calculating that they've got enough for themselves?
I think that's really important, and it's great to give with warm hands, as it's sometimes described. I think that's fantastic, and well done to these grandparents, the majority of them helping out the grandkids. But they do need to keep that in mind. In this MLC report, MLC gave some great tips on things like consider one's own pension situation, because giving money or gifting can have implications. And is it a gift or is it a loan? Because that also has tax implications. There are other factors to consider as well, like if they're helping out a grandchild by having them live in their home, that grandchild can make a family provision claim on the will eventually. So it's quite complex. And while it can be a simple sounding thing and a generous thing, professional advice can be useful if it's significant giving.
It's a lot more complex. My granddad used to just stuff a 20 into the pocket every time we'd visit and drive off down the driveway. But this, as you say, Mark, so implications for super and pension. Like if you're listening to that, you think, oh, too hard basket. How do they strike the balance?
Well, I think one thing to keep in mind, while we're talking about families and wanting to help our kids or grandkids, it can be good to put something in writing. We all know that young adults, they might move in, but are they going to leave? And if you have a little agreement, just both can sign, maybe they look at it each year and say, well, how's that loan going? Or we'll revisit this accommodation situation that we have. Maybe the support we're giving for education will be considered every year. We'll have a look at it so that it's not ongoing, never ending. Then I think people aren't being taken advantage of. It can be reassessed as that agreement falls due.
It's like a prenup.
You know? But with the grandkids.
Yeah, your granddad could have said, Matt, I'll just get you to sign something here as I'm giving you
He always hid it from Dad. It was always like subterfuge, like, here's a quick 20. It was great.
Mark, really interesting. Thank you.
Thanks, man.